Welcome back to the Boot Tragedy. We're going to talk about the Saints practice squad today, which I do think the Saints have one of the better practice squads in the NFL. Some of these guys could be on roster. Some of these guys can't actually be on the Saints roster. I think the Saints will make a couple more moves, like putting guys on IR, probably trying to trade some guys, and maybe adding one of these guys or two of these guys to the active roster, the 53. And we're going to start off with Kirk Merritt, who I think has the best chance to make the 53-man roster by opening day. Obviously, Kirk Merritt. He flashed in preseason, man, had speed. The Saints, played toy with his position at one point from receiver to running back. So, obviously, he has the talent, to make a 53-man roster. I'm actually surprised when he got waived that no other team picked him up. So, that's good news for the Saints. He was able to clear waivers, make it back to the Saints. So, he is on a practice squad. But my prediction is he will be on a 53-man roster somewhere on opening day. Next up, we got another receiver, Dejon Dixon, hometown kid, went to Nickel State, man. He's a good project receiver, a 6'4 guy. He's going to be tall, red zone type threat, which we really don't have on the team at receiver position. I guess you can call Michael Thomas, but he's not really a red zone threat. He's just an all-around receiver. So I think he's going to be a good project guy. Maybe he'll get moved up this year if, injuries happen or something like that. But I do think he has potential. Maybe next year will be, I think, the year for him to kind of make this roster. He's kind of reminds me a little bit of Lil Jordan Humphrey. I think he's going to be a little bit better than him. So we'll see. Next on the list, they have Josh Andrews, experienced offensive lineman, man, 31 years old, been around the league, played for 6-7 teams, played multiple positions, and you definitely need that on your practice squad because you never know if a center's going to get hurt, guard's going to get hurt, tackle's going to get hurt. You're going to need a guy that's versatile that can come in and play any one of those positions on the field, both sides of the line, left side, right side. So that's a good addition to the practice squad as well. Then you have Taco Charlton, defensive end. I think Taco Charlton had a very, very good preseason. Unfortunately, he's on the defensive line for the Saints. We know that defensive line is stacked, so it just was going to be hard for him to make that 53-man roster. But the good news for him, I guess bad news for Saints, is more than likely somebody on that defensive line is going to go down with injury at some point in the season. So he'll probably definitely have a chance to get moved up into that 53-man roster at some point in this season. Man, it's a 17-week season. It's almost impossible for people to be healthy the entire season, so I expect him to get moved up at least once or twice. Then we got DeMarcus Fields, who's a corner. I think this would be a full practice squad year for him. Don't think he'll have a chance to get moved up unless it's a couple injuries on the roster, and we knock on wood that doesn't happen. But I think he's a good project corner. Then we have Vincent Gray, who's another cornerback. I think he's the better of the two. He was very solid in the preseason for Michigan. He's long, he's lengthy, he can run a little bit. So I do expect him to probably get moved up this season, maybe once or twice, just because we have four cornerbacks on the roster: Deebo, Lattimore, Roby, and Alante Taylor. Deebo's been dealing with injury. Alante Taylor has as well. And Lattimore had a hamstring injury, so I wouldn't be surprised if he got moved up at any time this year. Chase Hansen, a linebacker. This guy was probably not going to make this team, not going to make this practice squad, but he showed up in the preseason and he showed out and he gave himself a chance to make this team, and on practice squad right now. I wouldn't be surprised if they shuffled a couple guys and he made that active 53 as well, but he did have a good showing in preseason. And honestly, Zach Bond made the top 53, so Chase Hansen probably could have got in there over him. Then you have JP Holtz. Do think he'll be a practice squad guy for the remainder of the season unless a couple of those guys at tight end get hurt. We have too many tight ends, man. Juwan Johnson, Troutman, Taysom Hill, Nick Vinette, and you also got another guy on this practice squad who I'm going to mention, Lucas Crawl, who's the other tight end. So he's kind of in the same boat. We already have four tight ends in front of those guys. It's going to be hard for those guys to get playing time this year. Lucas Crawl, definitely a project tight end. Hopefully he gets some playing time this year, but that means someone gets hurt. So we'll see how that works out. Then we have Jordan Jackson on the list. Next, defensive tackle. He's in the same boat as Taco Charlton, man. Defensive tackle position is very, very good for the Saints. Maybe he gets moved up, maybe not, but he's going to be another project guy, being our sixth-round pick. Then you got Nafee Sewell, undrafted free agent out of Utah. I think he's a really solid player. Maybe wasn't ready to play this year, on the defensive side of the ball. Could have been a special teams guy. Like I said, man, all of these guys still have a chance, for the most part, to get on that active roster. Maybe not week one, but at some point in the season, If I had to guess just off, you know, how NFL goes, 10 of these guys will probably be on the active roster at one point this season. That's just the NFL. That's the nature of the business. Then you have linebacker Eric Wilson, who was a surprise, actually, practice squad guy for me. Like I said, the Saints aren't done. They're still shuffling around some guys. They're putting guys on IR, which is going to free up some roster spots for some other guys. So Eric Wilson being on this practice squad, he may get moved up fairly soon. I can see him also being a candidate for the active 53-man roster when we play the Falcons. But he's a really good linebacker. Had a solid preseason as well, so I'm expecting him to get moved up. And last but not least, Rashid Shaheed. It's unfortunate that we didn't get to see him in the preseason, but I also think that was the Saints playing chess, man. If you remember Turpin from the Cowboys with a couple return punts and a punt return and a kickoff return for a touchdown in the preseason, if Rashid Shaheed went out there and did that, the Saints would not be able to hide him on their practice squad. So they're going to just have him on the practice squad rehabbing from injury. He was coming off the ACL injury, so they did want to be cautious with that. That guy is a hell of a returner, or he was in college, so I was definitely excited to see him. That was probably the biggest unfortunate thing in preseason that we got to witness, that we didn't get to witness, I guess, Rashid Shaheed. But receiver slash kick returner, we do have Deontay Hardy. We do possibly have Kirk Merritt as well, Tony Jones. So we have some returners, but I did want to see Rashid Shaheed out there. And that'll wrap up the Saints practice squad. Let me know what y'all think in the comments below. Which one of these guys are probably going to get moved up to the active roster fairly soon? Or who should we just knock off this practice squad and look for somebody else? And as always, this is the Boo Tragedy. Send them out.